Yeah, we broke the speed record. So, as you saw before, we managed to break our speed record. And I just wanted to take a few minutes to talk about the changes I did compared to the first version of the speed breaker. So, as you can see, here is the first version of the speed breaker. It is using two BuWizz motors and one BuWizz 3.0 to drive, and it used four wheels, two for driving and two for steering. So when we tested the first version, we discovered that it had a few problems. First, it wasn't really stable when going fast. And secondly, we were missing a few tens of kilometers an hour to break the speed record.
We almost broke the speed record. I mean, we were very, very, very close, which I think is a really good score for the first time.
And this is why I decided to build the second version. Now, what I changed for the second version? As you can see, compared to the first version, I changed the drive wheel because there was no way of increasing the gear ratio with the old one. I decided to use the new BMW motorbike's front wheel as the rear wheel for the new speed breaker. And the gearing was also changed. So the gearing is slightly slower, but the wheel is much bigger. So the overall model is around, I think, 8% faster.
This one should be heavier, but it shouldn't be twice as heavier.
The most important factor with these models is power to weight ratio. So the most that you can get the most power into the lightest model as possible. I think that's the key to having obviously high performance model. Another change I did was in the steering. The steering angle has been even more reduced compared to the version 1. So the steering lever is now this long and the steering angle is thereby reduced. And in this case, the whole front axle steers. It doesn't steer the individual wheels anymore, but the whole front axle steers, which allowed me to build the front axle much lighter and much more stable. And I also added the simple suspension in the front, so the car would be less sensitive to the bumps when driving over the rough asphalt. Another improvement was also this plane nose cockpit element that was added in the front with the hopes of reducing drag. I'm not sure if it really helped or not, but I think it looks good. So yes, these were the changes, and we managed to break the speed record. The model is not yet perfect. There are still some issues with stability when driving quickly and body flexing. That's why there are these wheels here. But I think we can improve it in the next version. I already have some ideas to go even faster for the next version. Two wheels on the back, two big ones. One in the front, same, all three the same size. And maybe we can put two more motors and we can still increase the gear ratio. So I'm not using the highest gear ratio you can here. You can still go higher. You can still replace. Currently I'm using 36 and 28 tooth gears. But you can increase this one to 40 and this one decrease to 24. So you can go even faster. But let's save that for next time. If you guys are as happy as we are for breaking this speed record, and if you are interested in the future records we will be breaking, then please, of course, subscribe, like and share. Thank you.